Hi, this is Marty Lyons of the New York Jets. You're listening to the Weekly Rant with Jim and Steve.
Welcome back to what are you doing over there?
I don't know.
Welcome back to another show of the Weekly Rant. This is our 25th episode, actually. Alongside Steve, Jimmy.
Yo.
And
you are a leprechaun.
Yeah. St. Patty's Day is around the corner. We got St. Patty's Day is a Monday, so what am I going to do? Put it on Tuesday?
Yes.
Looks like an idiot.
You look like an idiot right now.
What's
the difference?
Tried to outclass you, and I did.
No, I don't think you ever do.
No, I do. All the time. All
just
the time.
Wait until you start talking for real.
Speaking of class, breaking the class of 30 goalies, he's now the 29th goalie, Henrik Lundqvist, to win 300 games.
Was that a smooth transition to the rundown?
You like that, right?
No.
I do. Go ahead.
I'm up for the smooth transitions. That's not you.
Okay.
The Nets win again. They continue to impress. Are they going to swish through the competition?
You just killed the transition there. Speaking of killing transition, the Knicks, they back in the hunt.
Only three games back.
For a playoff spot?
That's why the
three
NBA
games
is,
back.
That's meanwhile, why the NBA sucks.
Meanwhile, there's 16 games over under 500.
If only the Mets can play in the NBA, we'll see what happens there.
That's a valid point.
The Weekly Rants weight loss competition comes to an end. We'll see if Kelly White is still in the lead or if one of our underdogs has catched him at the end.
That's true. And then, actually, whoever wins is going to come on. We'll give him a little... a champion's moment as well.
It's kind of like Jimmy's rant, but better.
What a douche. our debate this week. Our debate this week is going to be a good one and fitting for what's going on now at Phil Jackson. Whether he decides to come here or not, is he going to be a good fit for the New York Knicks organization?
Because baseball starts 3 weeks. 3 weeks. We're going to do our Major League Baseball predictions and power rankings.
Right? Come on. And after that, what else to do other than say the predictions? Who's going to beat the World Series other than his Oakland Athletics?
Which, who will win? Thank you very much.
Yeah.
We'll talk about Wichita State, 34-0, the first team since 2004 to go into the NCAA tournament undefeated.
And like everything else, we have bets, and like every other time,
you
I lose them all. We will have an NCAA bracket bet.
And last but not least, we'll have the white guy sitting next to me complain about something.
Yeah, buddy.
I may have to rant about Jimmy's farting.
It's not going to get you.
As Kelly lights a candle off screen because it smells so badly in this apartment. But King Henrik Lundqvist wins his 300th game, all 300 with the Rangers.
Yep.
And, you know, it's been a great career for Henrik so far. I mean, this season's been a little up and down since he's been splitting time with Cam Talbot. He struggled a little bit in the middle. But, you know, 300 wins is quite the accomplishment. As an Islander fan, I only hope we can get a goaltender in the near future that can win 30 games, let alone 300.
I'm glad you didn't say someone like Lundqvist, because if that was the case, then your goalie would spit over our people that clean up the ice, since Lundqvist did do that at Nassau Coliseum. He spit on one of the ice
guys. I want to knock that hat right off your head.
Well, don't do that. It's bad luck. yeah, Lundqvist, he's actually one win away from tying Mike Richter, who has the Rangers' all-time wins record of 301. He's currently tied with Eddie Jockman in 49 shutouts, which is the New York Rangers franchise record. And he did so against the Detroit Red Wings in an original six game where the Rangers actually did play well, not just win. They don't always play well when they win. They look kind of ugly. But had a standout
performance.
Unlike
the Islanders, who look ugly just losing.
The Islanders lose all the time. It's bad.
You know, speaking of bad, if you want to call in and join us, 609-975-9689. More than welcome to join. I mean, I know we're getting a call from John from Florida in a few minutes because that always happens.
Yeah.
But, you know, I just got a text from someone who says that you look hot.
Oh, I love a female.
Female.
Oh, yes.
But then she said I looked hotter. Sorry.
Oh. Must be a blurry side of the screen then. Lundqvist also has the third best goals against average on the Rangers in his history for 2.27 goals against. He's looked great. He really has. A lot of Ranger fans threw him under the bus and said we don't want him. A lot of fans are saying he's just lost it this year when he was coming into his contract season and what he was going to sign for. Wasn't playing so well while he was under the pressure and scrutiny from the fans. Then he finally did sign that deal for 7 years, and he didn't play potentially after that.
No, he did not.
Because people said now it's the pressure that he has to live up to the hype of being the highest paid goalie. Well, he's the king. So, well, once Talbot stepped in, he played great. And Lundqvist says, I got to do something about
this. What are they going to do about Talbot?
Knowing the Rangers, they're going
to
trade him.
Well, they have to. Yeah, what are they going to do with him?
Trade him. I mean, they're going to keep him in the playoff push.
To the New York Islanders for a fourth round pick.
They're going
to
use him the way they've used from their past of playoff runs, from Dunham straight through to Marty Biron. They're going to utilize a good goalie who has a future, just like they did with Al Montoya when they're going for the playoff pushes early in the early 2000s. And then they're going to lose him. Mm. So we'll see what happens. But Lundqvist, 300 wins. As a Ranger fan, that's great to see. Been to many, many games. And I actually went to his first game with John from Florida. Went to his first game. It was an exhibition game against the Islanders. I forgot who started, but the Rangers were down 4-1, in which they came back and won 5-4. So that was pretty neat. We're going to move along here now. The New York Nets. Jesus. The Brooklyn Nets. The Brooklyn Nets are really playing well here. And they're right now 31-30. I think it was last episode I was actually pointing out the teams that they needed to beat, in which they beat all those teams but one, being the Celtics. They're playing.
They got blown out by the Celtics.
They did. But you know what? They're playing a very important game tonight in the Raptors. They're three games back from the Raptors, and the Raptors are going for their second division title in their franchise history. And you know, right now the Raptors won two of the three games. The Nets won the first one in a blowout fashion. And the Raptors came back, and most recently they beat the Nets 104-103 back in December, or back in January. I'm sorry. They got to win this game. They really need to win this game. They beat the Bucks as they should have. The Bulls, great win. Grizzlies, another great win. Kings, that was expected. They lost to the Celtics, but again tonight the Raptors, they got to win.
Of course they got to win. What kind of? I mean,
they really don't. They're going to be in the playoffs.
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to make the playoffs in NBA. It's just ridiculous.
The East is bad.
You know. I can't wait to talk about college basketball later because that's a real sport. The NBA is we say this every single week. NBA is like wrestling. It's a bunch of made-up crap. Truly is. This is miserable.
Yeah.
You know, the biggest story in the NBA this weekend wasn't the fact that the Nets are surging or the Knicks are a debacle. It's the fact that LeBron James went to see Zildakis Iglesias or whatever his frickin' name. I can't even pronounce it. Television. to watch him get his number retired and whether or not he's going to come back to Cleveland. That's the biggest story. How about that most of your teams are under 500. It's not even a real sport anymore. You have Indiana, San Antonio, Miami, and Oklahoma City.
It's going to be bad when Brooklyn has two teams in that stadium and it's going to be under 500. Yeah. Your New York Islanders. But the Nets are still sluggish. They got injuries. And now it's coming down to the playoff push. They need to get everybody healthy. Pierce just went out with a shoulder injury. Who knows when Garnett's going to come back and actually be healthy. The guy's 95 years old. I don't know what he's going to do after
that.
No,
he's only 35. He's been around for that long.
I know. Well, he came out of high school.
Yes.
He came out of high school. But the Nets, they've won 4 of 5, 11 of the last 15. They look great since the beginning of the year. The beginning of the year in January, they lost just two games. And, well, those two games were to the Raptors. But, you know, they're going for the season split tonight. So we'll see what happens with that. And they won 7 in a row at home and 14-16 at home. They're home tonight.
They've been very good. They were built as a very good team. And Sean Livingston actually proven that he can play basketball. He came out, he was fourth overall pick from the Clippers. He busted out of LA because he was that bad. But then he found himself on the Nets. And you know, Jason Kidd's been a great mentor for him. And it's really been a pleasure watching. And just imagine if Brook Lopez didn't get hurt with his broken foot a few months ago. How good they can actually be. They've been dominant.
Yeah.
But they're still missing that big guy in the center.
And even when Pierce has been out, Marcus Thornton's come in, and he's played great for him, too. He's averaging over 20 points per game.
He was great with Sacramento.
They just played Sacramento, and he tore him up for 27 points, 15 in the fourth quarter.
Payback's a bitch, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely. 20 points three times this season, where he's only gotten 60 points in 46 games with the Kings.
I still can't believe we're talking basketball on the show.
Well, we're going to move right along to the Knicks.
I still can't believe. Actually, we're not talking basketball anymore. I don't know what this is.
Knicks are playing the center. 76ers tonight, who are 15-47. Everybody says, oh, this is an easy thing. Or it's a game that the Knicks should win.
I think they've lost 20 in a row, the 76ers.
16. Okay. They're going for 17 tonight. Their record is 20, which was back in 72-73. Yeah. That's kind of like the Islanders a couple of years ago, who lost 17. So the 76ers are...
Knock that right off your head.
Well, everybody says this game, the Knicks should win this game.
They should win.
They lost to the Bucks.
Yes.
How can they win this game if they can't beat the Bucks? Well,
the 76ers, at least the Bucks are trying. I'm not sure what the 76ers are doing.
They're just atrocious. They're fighting the Knicks for that for the most amount of what is it the bingo balls for the draft lottery balls. Yeah,
bingo balls,
whatever. Knicks are favorite.
Did you play bingo up in Villarama?
I did.
Okay.
I did. It was awesome. And that was hosted by Doc Holliday. It was awesome. The Knicks are favored by 15.5 points tonight.
Anyone know a bookie? I'll bet the Sixers.
They're favored by double digits, in which Carmelo Anthony is the only Knick who averages double digit points.
How about Carmelo Anthony is the only Knick that tries?
Yeah, well, he's just trying to get traded. That's all it is. He doesn't want to be here anymore.
Well, he can opt out at the end of the year, and the trading deadline's over.
And he's going to. And you know what? Joakim Noah, he wants to have
Melo. I don't think Melo opts out. If there's anything right for Melo's career, he does not opt out. He plays one more year, and he gets into the next free agency.
I think his max, if he goes elsewhere, is 24 and change a year.
It's 488 if he leaves, about 22 a year.
22, okay.
And if he stays with the Knicks, it's 5,130.
That's
but
disgusting.
If he stays in for one more year and then opts out next year when he can, he'd be in the market with LeBron and everybody else. And so a team that loses out on LeBron may really go all out on Carmelo.
Yeah, that's wow.
But the problem with the Knicks is Tyson Chandler doesn't try. He's not playing defense.
Mm-hmm.
J.R. Smith's garbage. Raymond Felton, I mean, he's good for carrying guns, but not for carrying the ball up the court.
That's about it.
They got nothing left. They are pathetic. They are absolutely
pathetic.
Their
past four games, I got to say, they have played well.
Why would you want to buy tickets to see the Knicks?
I have no idea.
Who would want to waste money to get there and then to feed James Dolan's pockets? I mean, it's just, at least when you go to a Ranger game, they have a chance of winning.
Yeah.
And you're paying the same crappy prices to get into the city.
The past four games, Stoudemire is averaging almost 17 points a game. J.R. Smith hit over 50% of his three-pointers. So they're saying, oh, wow, you know, maybe they'll make a run. Maybe they'll break through the Hawks, who are sitting in the eighth seed right now, which I don't think is going to happen.
Nope. But they can.
It just goes to show the Knicks is 16 games under 500. They're tied for 10th. Which is pretty bad. Now, the seventh seed, the Bobcats, they're five games under 500.
The Bobcats are in the playoffs?
Yeah.
That's how you know basketball
seven
is bad.
Games
forget
under
about anything else.
Eighth seed, nine games under 500, and they're in the playoffs. And like I wrote down here, no playoff team in the West Coast is even close to being 500 for the playoffs. It's just, it's unbelievable. The Knicks are 24-40. And, you know, at that 64 games in, they have 18 games left, right? I don't think they're going to win six of those. They're not going to win 30 games this year. They're going to lose more than 50 games. I haven't even
seen
the schedule.
How many games are left?
18.
You want to make a bet? Just so you can potentially win something?
Sure.
Okay.
Sure. They're not going to touch 30. They will not. Hey. So without touching 30 wins this year, we'll figure out a bet throughout the show.
I say they'll touch 30.
You think so? Okay.
They'll touch 30 and they won't even lose 50. I don't care.
Okay.
Doesn't make a difference.
We'll figure that one out. Do you think they'll pass the Nets?
No.
Okay.
Not even close.
I was going to try to make that bet, and then I'd really win something.
Do I look like an idiot?
Yep.
Nope. Says the guy wearing a leprechaun outfit.
I'm celebrating St. Paddy's Day. Give it up. Come on. What? All right. So, do you have any access to music? So we can get some sort of intro to the weight loss competition
music
here.
You know, I'm glad I don't
have...
like
a Rocky theme song.
Yeah, I have it.
It's kind of fitting.
Do I have it?
Well, look for it. As we get into the weight loss competition, and just to give you a little bit
I do. No, I don't. I have another song by Survivor.
We'll get something by Survivor. Because right after this, guys, if you want to go weigh yourselves in, you can let us know what you got there. Again, coming up on the debate, we'll be talking about Phil Jackson, going through baseball and the power rankings. Yeah. So, weekly rant with Jimmy and Steve weight loss competition comes down to this very last final day.
You know what they say. It's the final countdown.
Final weight down. Fat down.
Oh, unless in your case, you're just getting
it's
up.
The final fat up.
I weighed myself prior. I happened to not gain or lose a single pound the last month. I finished at 215. I started at 221. I've lost 6 pounds for the competition.
Oh, so I bumped up to you.
You bumped up to where I started.
221.5.
Yes.
I'm just filling out. That's all it is. Tommy
dropped out.
Yeah.
Tommy dropped out.
What did you finish at?
I just told you 215.
I told you I don't listen to you. Oh, so you didn't do okay.
I did nothing in the past month.
That's right. And my father stayed steady.
No, Jim dropped to 242.
242.
Good work, Jim.
That's muscle. That's biking muscle.
I mean,
that's biking muscle. And speaking of biking, again, on May 31st, if you go on our weekly rant page, my father's biking from, what is it, Freeport? Freeport or Babylon?
By Babylon. Out to, the 108. The 108 is Babylon.
The 108 out to Montauk. If you can please go on our website, we actually linked in his page, and he's accepting donations, and he's trying to create this fundraiser. It's for leukemia. So any donation.
Really? I thought it was for his new bike.
For the new $1 million bike, the new finger weight bike. So any donation will help. It goes a long ways to him, and he appreciates it, as does the entire organization. And if any of you can make it out there, if you go onto the general website, I'm sure you can buy tickets to get out there too. It's going to be a beautiful day. A lot of people will be out there. Again, the race is going to finish in Montauk Point. So it's a good cause. Again, if you go onto our website, which is, you know it by heart, since we changed everything, facebook.com/theweeklyrantshow, you'll see where we have the fundraiser set up. And again, any donation will go a long ways and really help out.
Absolutely. All right. So John, he did pretty well. He dropped about a little over 8 pounds.
Yeah.
Good for him.
Yep.
Kelly?
Well, actually, Kelly came in at 328.
And a half.
And a half. He dropped to 298 flat.
After the first month.
Right, which was 30 pounds, 29 and a half pounds.
Yeah, no, 30 and a half.
30 and a half.
Matt's your strong suit.
Obviously. What'd you final out at?
288 flat.
Hey.
All righty. There it is. Nice. That is 40 and a half pounds in 2 months.
288 flat. Oh, give it to you, Kel. Pretty sure you smoked this one.
And we'll see what happens, but, you know, we may. If Kelly wins, he'll have a few minutes to talk. He'll take my seat, and I'll get to do whatever I want for a few minutes.
Can I announce you? Wait, you cool with that? You cool with that, Dennis, if I announce you? You came in at 219 and a half. So, really, the competition came down between me and Dennis.
For
well, what? I was 219 and a half coming in, too.
Yeah.
I also stayed at 219 and a half.
No, you went
midway.
Up to 2.
No, in the midway. Now, Dennis lost, what is that, man?
Dennis lost 5.5 pounds after the first month.
Okay, so I lost right away.
You absolutely lost.
What do you got? Are you 221?
You gained weight.
Yes. Yes, what are you? What are you? Give me a drum roll. Give me a freaking drum. No, on your phone.
216.
Oh,
son of a bitch.
Jimmy comes in last. You know, you are the only person I know who gained weight in a weight loss competition.
That sucks.
You know what? We should do a weight gain competition next on the show, and you may lose weight.
Damn it.
Damn it. You stuffed your face with pork chops while you were asking out a girl at Croxley's.
They were good. They were good.
We went to Baronet's. You ate all the carbs on everyone else's plates.
They were delicious. They were right there. Come on. I took a little of each.
A little? You ate half of Megan's shepherd's pie.
Well, it was available, and she wasn't taking it home. Couldn't let it go to waste. Shepherd's pie. Irish. Look at this. I got to eat it.
Yeah, you got to fill up that costume.
No, I don't. It's full.
You keep the costume is full. You keep a freaking elf.
Well, the costume is full. So
losing 40 and a half pounds. Kelly, come on over here.
Get up here. Let's get that music back again.
What music?
Yeah, come on. Something. Anything.
No, I'm off the show now.
Oh, you are off. Oh, man. We should do this every week.
Thank you, guys.
Can you win every week? Kel, what's up, brother? All right, so you just won.
You want to take a...
I'll sit back here. I'll sit behind you.
Sit in the back?
Great. You see, if Jimmy sat on this chair, may break. And
you sure you want to sit back there? My flaps are open back here, you know.
Awesome.
Oh, you're stepping on them. You're sitting on them. There you go. All right. Anyway, so you lost 40 and a half pounds.
Yeah.
What did that win you? You had a choice, Yankee tickets or Mets tickets.
Yeah, what are you taking?
Tough decision.
It actually is.
Real tough decision.
Mets have a real nice stadium.
They have great food.
Yeah, but considering I'm not eating any of that right now... I'm going to go with my heart. I'm a Yankee fan.
There you go.
I got to take
you're going to get Yankee tickets.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So speaking of bets, that's Jimmy lost one too.
That's not all I won.
Jimmy lost a lot of bets, actually, in this competition.
Yeah. We had a side bet.
We did.
You want to fill everyone in?
No, not at all.
I really don't.
I'll do it.
Yep. Oh, okay. Please.
Jimmy bet Kel. If Jimmy lost more percentage weight, I don't know what you were going to get. What was going to happen?
I don't know. I didn't think I was going to win anyways.
I was going to go head-to-toe Giants.
Oh, yeah. And if Jimmy lost more weight, our May 6th show, which is our NFL draft show, we're going to have the studio filled with Jet jerseys.
I love it.
I love it, too.
Yeah.
I won without having to.
You're ready for it. You got all the green.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. Yeah, it's great. Can't wait.
and to make matters better.
Oh.
Me and you made a bet for our May 6th show. You're wearing a Mark Sanchez jersey.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, speaking of Mark Sanchez, I followed him on our Twitter account, which is twitter.com/.
Why would you do that? You're representing.
I also follow Cece Sabathia and a bunch of other people.
That's punishment even to a Jet fan.
Well, punishment to a Jet fan or not, I also have to wear a Mike Piazza jersey.
At the Met game. Well, you chose it. I was going to offer you a Jose Reyes, a David Wright, Mike Piazza.
Yep.
Mike Piazza.
Yep.
Mike Piazza.
Yep.
Yeah, you look
like Mike Piazza. How many more Mike Piazza jerseys you got? But I wanted the black
Johan Santana.
No. That's a fake no.
Matt Harvey.
You have the bright orange.
I do have the bright
full
orange.
Full bright. Oh.
The chapter collar.
No, you gave me the option.
I know. I'm giving you the option. You can choose whichever one you want, but I do have the traffic cone, Matt Harvey jersey.
Oh, no, I was going to say, don't you know, Piazza in the black one, but he has the gray one.
I do have
one
Piazza in the black one.
I know, that's what I want.
Okay.
All right, I can respect
you
wanna
that. You want to wear Piazza, that's fine.
How about you get out of here? Dennis, you come on up here.
Okay.
Oh, I have so much power right now. I love it. It's the suit.
No, it's because you fart.
Oh. Oh, my God. Now, it's easy to squeeze behind Kel. Nowadays, at least. He lost 40 pounds. What's happening, brother?
What's going on?
So now you lost.
I lost weight and then I gained weight.
But overall, you lost weight. You lost, where is it?
You lost 3 pounds. Yeah.
I gained 3 pounds. So you're good. I did. So what happened?
Was it that? It started off better than it ended.
So well, I believe the first night it started. The second night it started. You came over and we had corned beef.
Yeah, yeah.
So we worked our way onto the right foot there.
Yeah,
that was good.
And then it was all downhill.
Now you were going back to the gym. You started eating healthy.
I know. We met up.
Yeah.
We did some working out.
He spotted me from the first rep all the way through.
It was great.
I wanted to kill you for the rope that you did there.
Oh, the rope thing.
The battle
rope. The battle rope. Yeah.
God, that was
get
just.
Get your shoulders good.
I think at one point I really did want to throw up. That happened. I sweat like a behemoth. And it wasn't good. I did more gym watching than anything else.
Yeah, well, you know what? You can reap the benefits of gym watching, too.
Yeah, you can.
Get a little bit of a pump.
Yeah, you can. Someone walks by, you want to look a little bit bigger.
That's really a special pump.
Yeah.
I believe that would be a Swedish-made penis enlarger. Wait, what are you talking about?
Wow.
Hey now.
What pump are we talking about? How do I know they're Swedish? Come on. anyways, so a moment of silence. So, are you guys going to continue? That's the big question.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah?
I have to do better. I'm a little disappointed by second.
Yeah, I remember I heard from Dennis yesterday, and I says, hey, so you're going to make it down for the final day of the competition? His response was, well, there's a problem with you doing it on Monday. Oh, well, what's that? I need more time.
Yeah. I need like another 4 weeks or so.
Well, but, appreciate you being here.
It's great. It was great.
Congratulations to the both of you. You lost weight. I lost losing weight. And I wish you guys can stay much longer right now. Steve, come back.
Enjoy your
films. I give you permission. You can come back. Now, I would have left, actually, and had you stay here, but my fat ass won't be able to get around all the way, so...
Yeah, I would have enjoyed hanging out with Kelly and Kelly
stuck over here.
You know, though, we could keep the weight loss competition going for a little while longer.
Yeah, sure.
We don't actually have to, like, make it a real-life competition anymore. No bets, but, you know, for the sake of healthiness and everything, I'm down. I'm down to keep up. Cheers, guys.
Keep it going.
And for anyone else who wants to join now, You can send us an email at jimmysrants@gmail.com. You can find us on facebook.com/theweeklyrantshow. You can tweet us on twitter.com/weeklyrant or at weeklyrantshow, or you can call us 609-975-9689.
And speaking of competitions,
you want to lose something else to me?
No. This is
the, Yes, I'm sorry. So we're talking about it in a few minutes.
Actually, no, we'll get to that.
No, you know, we might as well just throw it out there because that way people can have more than one chance to think about it.
Okay.
March Madness means brackets. So if you want to join the weekly rant bracket, I currently actually do run a bracket with a friend. Send me an email at jimmysrants@gmail.com. I'll give you the information. $25 buy-in. Going to be a good time. Winner gets,
What do you have, like 40, 45
We have about 40, 45 people in from last year. So it depends if they all come back. But if you're interested, let me know. Let Jimmy know. Let the world know. And it'll be a fun time.
That's about it. And speaking of competitions, I mentioned it last week. We do have a lot of ideas for competitions. If you have any ideas of competitions you want Steve and I to do, just, again, email us at jimmysrants@gmail.com. But we'll be doing more stuff on the road as far as anything from...
Can we do a competition, find me a new co-host?
Yeah, you can, absolutely.
All right.
Ghost Chili Wing Challenge.
Well, close.
No, thank
you. We're going to be doing a cook-off challenge.
Ghost Chili Challenge? Jimmy can't control his ass.
I'm having problems tonight. I'm having problems.
I'll be watching, not joining that one.
I won't be watching. I'll be waiting.
So we'll be doing anything from rifle range challenge to a cook-off challenge.
Again, you're going to have to find a new co-host if you do a rifle range challenge.
We're going to be doing some batting challenges, try and hook up with the Long Island Ducks and see what we can get going on there. I'm so sorry for what just happened. So
yeah, I think they heard it on the microphone.
Oh, that's not good.
I can curse now because you fart on the air.
I'm not swearing. I'm just relieving. Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
My ass
is a better reliever than what the New York Mets
have
right now.
I'm reliving it. I'm reliving it. Jesus Christ.
We need a candle. That'll cause an explosion. In which my apartment almost did explode.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. It almost exploded. I think we may be better off. Yeah.
Oh, then again, one jersey, two jersey,
are they starting
jersey,
to melt?
Four. No, I got to take home that Real Lawyers Wear Orange shirt.
Why is
this in the middle?
Yeah, it only took you 4 weeks to realize that.
And I put the Red Sox jersey back there a few weeks ago, too.
It'll be all green soon.
One quest.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, my God. I got up and it smells worse. Oh. Yep, I sat down. So, debate. Let's get into it. Can you breathe? You all right?
No.
You need a gas mask? Just come back here.
Why would I want to come back there? I don't want to die.
Why are you taking that? You don't need that. So, the debate. The Zen Master. Is he a good fit for the New York Knicks?
And we go a little something like this. Hit it.
In honor of Mike Woodson.
Yeah. Well, no, where are we going to... You can keep that up a little bit.
Yeah.
Where are we going to actually have music for the debate?
Too lazy.
Well, now we got it. We should keep this song.
We should keep this song?
Why not?
No.
It's the first time we're playing song for a debate.
I'm going to dance.
Don't.
You can fart, I can dance. Anyway. Debate. What is it? You can go first.
I did the past 3 weeks, actually. Last week is my birthday, thank you.
And I still kick the crap out of
you. What a great birthday gift last week. Freaking Callahan. I'm over it.
You're over it?
Not at all. Go ahead.
Alrighty. Our debate. Phil Jackson is apparently on the verge of signing a contract with the New York Knicks as the front office guru. Phil Jackson of the Chicago Bulls, LA Lakers. And I think that's it. Yeah, that's it. Winner of 10 championship titles with these teams as coach. I think this is an excellent idea. The Knicks are a disaster. Why not hire a winner to run their front office? I don't see what's wrong with this. There's nothing wrong with it. He can bring a winner's attitude. Fire Mike Woodson. Get a real coach in there. I mean, Tone Lock should not be coaching the freaking New York Knicks. I can't see how anyone can think this is debate. It's easy. Yes, hire him.
I can't see how you think the Knicks never hired a winner. They did actually write this down here before. Donnie Walsh was a winner before he came to the Knicks. All right. It's a terrible idea. Just to go over a couple of things here, when he played for the Knicks, he actually was on a team that won two championships. So that's great. He has a little bit of a history being 11 seasons with the team. It's great. Why not come here? Bulls and Lakers, you know what he did there in his 21 seasons. Total of 13 championships. Coached for 11 of them, won two of them. Coach here at the Bulls, all-star game coach. He has a great, great resume. What is he now, 68 years old?
So?
Okay, so 68 years old, you just came out of retirement, and now you want to get involved in the New York Knicks organization. It's not going to put a damper on your career, your illustrious career, in one way, shape, or form. But you're now going to get involved in New York Knicks after all that? Come on, Phil, you know better.
Phil, you said it yourself, Phil was on two championship Knicks teams. He wants to make the Knicks a winner again. The Knicks haven't won a championship since he was on the team. They haven't won since 73. You know, they made it to the championship in 99. They lost to the Spurs. They lost to the Rockets in 94. But they haven't really been anything in particular. He's got a lot to work with if he comes to the Knicks.
They were there in 2000 also.
No, it's the same year. Whatever. It was 99-2000 when they played the Spurs. Doesn't make a difference. It's the same thing. He has a lot to work with. Carmelo's contract's coming off the book next year. Tyson Chandler's contract's coming off the book next year. Amari Stoudemire's contract's coming off the book next year. J.R. Smith will be gone. They have so much to work with. Phil Jackson is an icon. He brings people to teams. Everyone wants to come play for Phil Jackson. You know, even though he may not be the coach, he'll find somebody in his system that can work with him. I don't understand how this is a bad thing. He can bring the triangle offense to New York. It worked everywhere he went. L.A., Chicago, it worked. You get the right players to fit the system, they're going to be a good team. This is great. You know what, Donnie Walsh? He never got the full autonomy that he wanted when he first came there. You think James Dolan's going to be able to stand up to Phil Jackson? Hell no.
That's just because of the height difference. Come on now. James Dolan will stop Phil probably any way he possibly can because James Dolan is a freaking douche. That's it, plain and simple.
You're a douche.
I am a douche. So he's going to come in here. And yeah, he may bring that triangle offense, but guess what? The Knicks haven't been able to be coached since the Isaiah Thomas years, and they haven't been able to be coached now. It doesn't matter if they have Carmelo Anthony or not, Stoudemire or not. They cannot be coached. They are a terrible run organization from Donnie Walsh straight through to Steve Mills.
Donnie Walsh is no longer there. Did you just say Donnie Wall Street?
No.
Okay.
I said Donnie Walsh through Glenn Grunwald, through Steve Mills, and now they're going to go with Phil Jackson. The name, it's like having a name on paper. It's great to have him for the president of basketball operation of the Knicks. What the hell are you going to do? No one's going to want to come here and play. The only way they'll come here and play is if Woodson's gone and if the Knicks get either Mark Jackson or Tom Thibodeau as the coach. That's basically it. Otherwise, no one's going to want to come here and play for the Knicks. Never mind it being an iconic organization. Never mind it being for Phil Jackson. The hell's he going to do? He's in the office. He's a novice when it comes to this. He's never been a GM before. That goes for any sport. Not every time where you see a great basketball player or a great coach go ahead and excel to something better in the organization. To me, it's taking a chance. It's taking a risk. And maybe James Dolan will say, yeah, do what you want to do with the money. Go ahead. Let's see what happens. Because like you said, all the contracts coming off the books. But who knows? You really want to take a chance with that? I don't think so. I don't think so.
Okay, I got five words for you, Jimmy, and that's the end. This is going to be the end of my portion of the debate. It can't
wait, get... Wait, did you say you had five words for me and you counted on two hands?
No, I counted on one. I just had to... Okay. It can't get any worse. That's five words. I counted three times.
Okay, sure. Well, look, the Knicks are a mess. I honestly think that Phil Jackson needs to either stay retired or
go
to
the Knicks.
No, the Bulls or the Lakers.
Why would he go to the Bulls or the Lakers?
Well, because if he can't go there, I think he should pair up with Michael Jordan in Charlotte.
Wow,
how cool would that be?
Not at all, because he should be with the Knicks. But again, we're talking about more basketball.
We are. There's no winner when we talk basketball in a debate.
We're all losers, including you guys. So please call in 609-975-9689. Yeah. Isn't that right?
It's right here.
Yeah, best in number? Not 975-6986? No? No. 975-9689? Baseball season's coming up, and with that, we've already had some major injuries. Most of them happening to the Atlanta Braves, which makes me happier than a pig in mud. Yeah. Chris Medlin going down with a forearm strain, possibly out for the year.
Brandon, what was the other one?
Brandon Beachy going down with elbow tendonitis.
Because of?
No, that's Mike Minor.
Oh, that's my yeah.
Mike Minor having shoulder tightness because he had surgery on his, and I'm going to quote Deadspin, a very, very good source, his dick hole. Yes, Mike Minor had urinary tract surgery.
They said it, we didn't say it.
Urinary tract surgery in the off season, and he may not start the season. So right now the Atlanta Braves have Julio Teheran and no one else in their starting rotation. But baseball's around the corner. Great. Games being played. The Mets lost 11-1 today against the Marlins. In which, actually,
it's spring training.
I don't know if you saw this, but at the game today, Giancarlo Stanton hit a bomb, and these two guys went for the ball, and one guy was holding a stroller and let go of the stroller to catch the ball, and the stroller almost went straight into the fence. Now, before we go anywhere,
wait, was there a kid in the stroller?
Yes.
Oh God.
He caught the stroller first.
Oh.
But how far is too far? I know this is not really a debate, but you know,
well,
you
how far did he run with the stroller?
It almost hit the fence. It was pretty close. The stroller was on a hill. He let go of the stroller and rolled down the hill.
And who caught the ball?
The guy next to him. Oh. But the thing is, you see these sports in the top 10 plays where the guy catches the ball in his beer. The guy catches the ball with a baby in his hand. What the hell's wrong with you? A souvenir you can go to Sports Authority for $5. Or your kid.
Well, they're both alive, so I think he was hoping that when that was going to happen, that would be the outcome. And now it's a great story.
It's a great story.
Now it's a great story.
Your Sports Center number one play. You caught a ball. I caught a ball once.
Wait, speaking of Sports Center, is the Mark Sanchez butt fumble still worse?
No, they retired. They retired it after.
Oh, that's right. They did retire it. Yes.
Yes.
I wonder if that'll come out of retirement like Phil Jackson.
Anyway, I caught a ball once. One ball. One ball in a Major League Baseball game. Let me tell the story.
Please elaborate.
All right. So it was June 20th, 2006.
Make it PG.
It was my first. No.
Wow.
It was the first ball I caught.
It was my first girl.
Where's your head? It was my first ball I ever caught.
Okay.
I'm going to smack the freaking head off your head. I'm at Citizens Bank Park in Philly.
It was my first ball.
And the Mets play the Phillies. I'm in left field during pregame warm-ups, and Pat Burrell, Pat the Bat, steps
You're in left field. Yeah. You're playing left field.
I'm in left field. I'm over the fence in left field. I have my glove on, and Pat Burrell hits one.
How old were you?
20.
I had my glove on. How old are you? 20. Taking it too far? That's too far. You bring a baseball mitt to a game still.
Not anymore.
Did that stop? When you were 25?
Well, when I caught the ball when I was 20. It was the last time I ever brought to the game. Anyway, so ball's hit. I'm standing there. Bunch of little kids nearby. I leap over them.
What a dick.
Caught the ball. And then I walked.
And ran.
Walked briskly, actually.
Okay. Briskly, yeah.
Great game. Pat Burrell autographed the ball for me.
Wow.
Wow. It's worth nothing.
I know.
He was the first overall pick.
Wow. That's great. It's awesome.
So, Jimmy thought it'd be a great idea to do power rankings of all 30 teams.
I mean,
because Jimmy actually spent the time to do power rankings of all 30 teams.
Yeah, it's like an hour. But it was all right. I got them. What do I think? I don't know. We'll see what happens.
All right. You want to go through them? Because I didn't do it.
Well, who's your worst team? I think we agree on something anytime ever.
If I had to say who's my worst team, it'd be a toss-up between the Houston Astros and the Chicago Cubs.
Damn it. I played a little favoritism, and I say little because I only moved them up to the 27th spot because I actually wanted to have them at 30.
Yeah, the Houston Astros are awful. I mean, they have some good players. They really do. Holy shit, my team. Oh, I'm in the middle of a fantasy draft, and they do it through email, and it goes on. And I was hoping no one was going to take Matt Harvey because he was out. Someone took Matt Harvey. God damn it, I'm pissed now.
I wasn't listening to you.
Anyway,
so
Houston Astros are bad. Minnesota Twins, they're bad, but they have good enough players that they're not going to be that bad. And they play in the worst division in baseball, yeah. The AL Central. So doesn't make a difference. They can at least win a few games. They're not that bad. I'm looking at your list. The Marlins, they're bad. Cubs, they're horrible. And the White Sox, really.
You know, I'm actually second-guessing one team here on the list.
The New York Mets?
I actually am. I'm second-guessing them. And we do have another bet that we haven't come up with of how many games they're going to win under over. And I'm actually taking the
under.
The under on Vegas is 73.5.
Idiot.
Which doesn't make sense for this here. I don't think they're going to be 24th. I think they're going to be in
27th.
No. Right in the above 20, 22, 23. They'll definitely be worse than Philadelphia. But that actually rounds out their division, other than the Marlins. But I don't think that they'll finish 24th. I got to change that around. Maybe I'll swap that with the Mariners, because I don't think they'll be any good either, to be honest. But as far as number one goes, I struggle with that one. Texas. I went with Texas.
I mean, you may think that I have to take Oakland. I'm not. Even though I think Oakland will win the World Series, we'll talk about that a little later. I don't think Oakland's the best team. I just think that they're going to have the most advantageous route to the playoffs and through the playoffs, and they're going to win when it counts.
Not lucky like Colorado was a few
years
ago.
Not lucky like Colorado, but they're going
down the stretch that way.
They're going not even play on the stretch. They don't have the best team. But the best team doesn't win the World Series every year, and I just think the Oakland Athletics have the right composure and the right team to do it. I actually think my number one team would be the St. Louis Cardinals. Their pitching staff's unbelievable. Their hitting is ridiculous. Matt Holliday has been the steadiest guy that you've never spoken about in the past 8 years.
Waka waka waka
is great. Shelby Miller. They have a great pitching staff. They have a great bullpen led by Trevor Rosenthal and Jason Mott's coming back from his offseason from Tommy John from the year before. Mm-hmm. They got Johnny Peralta in the offseason. They have Matt Carpenter at third base. They have got Matt Adams, who's a potential 30 home run guy, on the bench. They don't even have room for him.
Oh, God. I got to see if I'm going to pick in this one, actually.
So, I mean, the St. Louis Cardinals are a great team. You ranked the Yankees third. I don't think they're in my top 10. I don't see.
That was me being biased. 100% biased.
Well, because you can't pick them ahead of the Red Sox. I understand that. Mm-hmm. I have the Braves making the playoffs and the Nationals, but I don't have the Mets in the playoffs. I'm not a giant homer, but I do like the Mets.
You can be a homer all you want. The Mets don't stand a chance anyways.
Well, neither do the Yankees. That was a good rank.
They stand a chance.
Do you want to hear Let's Go Mets Go again?
Do you want to hear the Mets first pitch again?
Yeah. No, I don't. Not really.
All right. So your predictions. We can talk a little about the predictions here.
Predictions. We got some more power rankings to talk about.
You want
to
talk about the power rankings, guys?
Who do you think is going to be your surprise team this year?
Well, from what I have here, it comes down to, actually, when you say surprise, it comes down to the team that I was surprised to see make the playoffs the way they finished the season, being the Pirates.
Surprise can be good or bad.
Yeah. My surprise, and that's why I say them, my surprise is going to be the Pirates not making the playoffs.
That's not really a surprise, though. I think most people are picking the Pirates not to make the playoffs.
Okay. As far as from what it was last year, they won over 90 games for the first time in seven. Well, actually, they finished the season.
Not the first time.
They finished over 500 for the first time in 17 years. That's what that was.
Yes.
But as far as making the playoffs, I don't really have a surprise per se in making the playoffs. If I had to give you one, I'll be honest here. The Yankees.
Yeah, they have to be.
Yeah, I got to go with the Yankees.
That's be a surprise. I honestly have, I'm pretty true to form in my picks, unfortunately. I think if you have to do a surprise, I can't even do it. I really think maybe the Rays winning the division. I think that may be my biggest surprise.
I would agree with that. I don't think the Rays are going to make the playoffs.
Oh, well, you can never go against a Joe Maddon coach team.
I can never go against you making that statement. That's very true.
I mean, Joe Maddon is excellent. And they know how to make the most out of the little. You know, the Knicks make the little out of the most.
Their organization is the perfect example
the
of money.
Rays, I actually bought a new book by Jonah Curry. I can't wait to read it. How they were able to take Moneyball to the next level when it came.
I was
going to
say because they're Billy Beane's junior team, basically.
Absolutely, but you know I'm excited to see what the Rays are going to do this year. They still have Ben Zobrist, who is one of the most underrated players in baseball. They have David Price. They never traded him. They have Will Myers in right field. They have guys that they don't even know what to do with them. They have so many good players on that team. Still Longoria. And you know they sign these team-friendly deals. They keep it going.
Do they have Soriano now?
Which one?
Raphael.
No, he's in Washington.
Did he go back? Oh, he went to Washington. Yeah, I forgot if he went back to Tampa or not. Okay.
Someone did go back to Tampa this year. Wow. I'm trying to think who it was.
Strong. I forgot.
My surprise team, you know, I'm looking at your list, and you really don't have much faith in the Diamondbacks.
They were going to be one of my wild card picks. I didn't know who the wild card for me in the National League killed me. I didn't know who
it's
going to be.
It's tough. I think Diamondbacks are going to come in second place in the NL West this
year. That was my toss up between the Pirates, the Reds, or the
Dodgers. Dodgers are far and away the best team in the West. But I really think the Diamondbacks are a really good team, and they did make a lot of good moves. They got Mark Trumbo in the offseason from Anaheim. They did trade Tyler Skaggs, who's going to be a great pitcher for Anaheim now. And they did trade Adam Eaton, who is the center fielder. But they have a good team. They have A.J. Pollock in center. They have Mark Trumbo now in right field. They still have Paul Goldschmidt, who's a perennial MVP candidate. And they signed Bronson Arroyo in the offseason, who is a pretty good pitcher. They have a good bullpen. They got Addison Reed in that Adam Eaton deal. They're gonna turn some heads. I don't think it's going to be enough to make the playoffs, but Kevin Towers is like the Joe Maddon of general managing. You can't go against Kevin Towers. Every move he makes has a purpose and will go. I mean, who knows where they are? And Archie Bradley, he was a top pick for the Diamondbacks 2 years ago. He's going to have one hell of a season when he comes up. So it's going to be exciting to see what the Diamondbacks do in the future.
You know, I speaking of all the wild cards and everything, and going through the list of the National League teams, you know my opinion on Kershaw and his contract.
Well, his contract's excellent.
We're not going to get into this again, because I still think I won that debate.
Nope.
I never hope for
an injury,
anything bad to happen to anybody. I'm not going to wish injury upon him at all. I just hope he doesn't win a single game. I hope he goes 0-162, let's just say. I hope he doesn't win.
Bupkis?
Basically.
I'm speaking Yiddish now.
Sure. I really don't want to see him succeed this year. I really don't. I can't stand the contract. I just want to see them collapse. Absolutely collapse. And to be honest, I also don't like Puig. So I also really, really, really want to see them collapse.
Not going to happen.
No, I know it's not going to happen.
Not at all.
What, as far as your playoffs go,
yeah.
What's going on there? What do you got?
Well, let's talk about the AL first. I have the Rays winning the AL East. The Tigers winning the AL Central because there's no one else.
Yeah.
I mean, you can make a claim for the Royals, but that's just not going to happen. Not this year. Oakland in the AL West. Boston in the wild card. And Texas in the wild card. And I actually have Texas after the wild card round coming out as the fourth playoff team.
Okay. I have... I'm going to go Homer style on this one. I got the Yankees in the East. Like you, I have the Tigers coming out of the Central. Rangers coming out of the West. My wild card, to me, was kind of tough. I got the Angels. I only picked the Red Sox for the other one because I picked the Yankees as a homer, in which I really do think the Red Sox are going to make the playoffs one way or another. But I'm putting them as the wild card.
Okay. I have the Oakland and the Rays being my ALCS, with Oakland, obviously, coming in the World Series.
Oh, National League. I have
You haven't done your AL.
Oh, sorry. Rangers. I got the Texas Rangers going to the World Series.
Okay, so we both think AL West.
Oh, you said the Rangers too?
No, I said the Oakland A's, but they're both in the AL West.
That's right, Jesus. You. I'll write something down for once.
Hopefully, good for you.
Right? Forgot how to write.
You forgot to do a lot of things.
Thank you.
I just wish, you know, we watch these radio shows, we listen to the radio shows, and they always have good music cued at the right time. You know why they have good music cued at the right time?
Because they have good hosts.
I'm a good host.
I didn't phrase that response good enough.
No, well enough. But.
Go on.
They have extra people who can sit there. Yeah. I'm sitting here talking. Thank you. I'm sitting here as I'm talking, trying to find good songs. I can't. It's impossible.
Because your music selection sucks.
I have 8,500 songs on here. 8,500. And I can't find anything.
Why do you have 8,500? This is 8,500 songs made? What's your National League stuff, by the way?
Do you want me to answer the question first? There was 8,500 songs.
God, I can't find it.
I just like the song. My NL picks. NL picks. All right, so we got Washington in the NL East. And you know the song's about someone picking races.
No.
Good song.
I don't know the song.
It's the whole study, Chips Ahoy.
Okay.
All right. St. Louis in the NL Central. LA in the NL West. And the Braves and Cincinnati win the wild cards, with Cincinnati knocking off the Braves in the wild card round.
I'm not going to take it as far as you.
Normally.
Moving along here. In the East, I got the Washington Nationals. I actually want to get down there this year. I haven't been to the stadium.
Ready right now?
I see a Nationals game.
Oh, it's a lot of fun. I'm probably going to go down in August.
I want to go. I want to take a look at that. I want to see a stadium.
Maybe they'll let us do a show there. Don't get your hopes. They won't let us do a show. All right.
At the Central, Cardinals, the West, Dodgers. Again, the wild card in the... Why are you guys talking music and not... You turn it off when I'm talking. I have fun with it.
I understand. I'm trying to find better music for you.
Or worse. Wild card for me, again, it was tough for the National League. The wild card, I have the Braves and the Reds coming out. And it was a toss-up between, for me, the Pirates and for the Diamondbacks. Is this supposed to be an insult or is this...
Yes, actually. The name of the song is Middle of Nowhere, which is where most of us go when you start talking.
Cardinals versus the Rangers. I have the Cardinals coming out.
Sorry, I'm having fun. Are you going to stab me with a pen?
What?
Actually, this song does have something to do with real life. This was in...
has something to do with you.
It was in the last MVP baseball game.
I don't play MVP. I don't have PlayStation.
No, MVP hasn't been around since 2006.
And it was PlayStation.
Yes.
Oh, I never... I had it. I always had Xbox.
Mm.
That's a lie.
What's your rank gonna be today?
I'm gonna actually have a toss-up. Don't worry about that. Who do you have for the...
Oh, I have Oakland beating Washington. Exactly.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm cool with that because I want to see Washington make it.
No, Washington's got a great team. Their pitching staff, Doug Fister, would be an ace on half the teams in Major League Baseball. He's the fourth starter. Their fifth starter is a competition between Tanner Roark and Russ Detweiler, who, again, will be a three starter on most teams. Taylor Jordan is not even starting in that rotation. He's a good pitcher, good young pitcher. They're going to have a stacked bullpen. Soriano, Drew Storen, great bullpen. They have hitting. They have Jason Worth. They have Bryce Harper. Come on. I can't even think of him off the top of my head. Ryan Zimmerman, Ian Desmond. Anthony Rendon, that team is stacked from top to bottom. Wilson Ramos is going to hit 20 home runs as the catcher position this year, and only 450 at-bats most likely. This team is great. I just think Oakland's going to come and finally win the World Series and vindicate Moneyball.
Why did you hesitate, though?
I had to think of the right word. Sometimes I think...
Terrible time to hesitate.
Oh, that's all right.
That's what
she said, yeah. All right.
Terrible time to hesitate.
I don't know. I'm tired.
That's what she said. Hey, let's get...
That's what they say to you all the time.
No, they... Shut up. Oh, Wichita.
State.
What you think you're going to say about Wichita?
Well, Wichita State is going into the... You missed. Did you hit yourself in the head? I couldn't say.
No, but there's no Irish basketball players other than Larry Bird. Where'd that go? Here it is.
I don't know. Anyone want to double check that?
Yep.
Yep.
Yeah! All
right. There's only one Jewish basketball player.
I was going to say, nice job, Doug Gottlieb.
Anyway.
Hey, he's in the Jewish Basketball Hall of Fame.
And
the Jewish Sports...
And on Wikipedia, I'm in the Jewish Sports Hall of Fame. Then they banned me from updating on Wikipedia.
Good. Go on. Wichita State Shockers.
The Wichita State Shockers shocked the NCAA, going 34-0 and winning the MVAC? What conference are they in?
What music is this?
It's depressing music because we're talking about Wichita State and being one of the best teams in college basketball.
No, we're talking about basketball.
Yeah. See? It's depressing.
This is hard. Just put on one of those Slit Your Wrist country songs that I hate.
Awesome. Okay.
I love country music, but I hate the Slit Your Wrist country songs. The new one, I forget who sings it, where he's sitting on the edge of a cliff.
Oh, on the pier? Luke Bryan?
Maybe. It's a terrible song.
It's called Drink a Beer.
That's it, yeah. I love country music. I love it. I hate those slow songs where the words are like... You just lost someone. You want to stab yourself. You want to jump off a cliff.
It's emo music.
Your tractor ran out of gas and you don't know what to do because now your cow's going to die because you can't get all the milk. You know, it's just like, all right, enough.
You mean this one?
Yes.
All right, your Irish basketball players. Bill Walton.
Bill Walton.
Chris Mullen.
Chris Mullen.
Kevin McHale.
Kevin McHale, great.
John Stockton. Great.
John Stockton.
Yep.
It's just because he's really white.
He is really white. Well, is Jeff Hornacek one, too? You can't find that one?
Not on this list.
Dan Marley? Danny Ainge. Come on. No, I'm just
me. That was just the top five.
Top. How about current?
Did you say Chris Mullen?
Yes, he did.
Okay. Yes.
How about current NBA basketball players?
All right.
Current. Yes. We're still talking about basketball, so we still got the press.
None, they're all at the bar. So.
Anyway, Wichita State, 34-0, won their conference championship yesterday. Most likely going to be a number one seed in the tournament. Probably the second overall seed. That's going to go to Florida, who went 19-0 in the SEC. Got to see what happens in their championship, though. If they don't win the SEC, there's a really good chance that Wichita State will go in as the top overall seed. Now, Jimmy, I know you don't know anything about sports, but, I mean, college basketball, but...
We'll cross St. Louis off the list.
St. Louis is a top team.
Let's cross them off the list.
What do you think about Wichita State?
They played Oklahoma Baptist, Emporia State, William & Mary, Tulsa, Bradley, Loyola, Evansville. What the freak are these damn teams? Who are they playing against? Like I told you before the show, if they want to be the number one team, you pulled out the Bill Parcells line.
Well, they're 34-0, aren't they?
They are 34-0.
All right, so, and then I said to you, what if they played one of the high schools on Long Island? 34 games. Your response?
Well, they'd be 34-0.
They're playing none of these top teams that, I don't want to say I've never heard of, because, okay, I hate basketball, but I'll watch college basketball. I'm not going to follow it so much. Other than the kid from Creighton, who's clearly going to go number one.
Doug McDermott's not going number one.
You know
what? Jabari Parker. Josh Edwin.
My point. Who cares? It's freaking basketball. Who cares?
Andrew Wiggins.
Who cares?
Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle.
The best part about college basketball is a damn bracket. That's it. And the fact that actually college basketball is better to watch because these kids actually have something to play for something. No, they got 4 years
at most. I think I broke the pen.
No. I had a lot of them break. These kids actually have something to play for. Being that they're there for a max of 4 years. NBA players.
Most of them are just there for
one now. Actually, what was they did something for the guy from, I forget what college, but he was known for flopping. Michael something or other. He was introduced during one of the games. And he's all over the news for being the biggest flopper in college basketball. And there were letters that were posted to the students' dorms saying, everyone who's going to tonight's game, we want you to attend and actually be involved in what we're going to do. Every time this guy goes to the foul line, or actually when he gets introduced, everyone starts flopping and yell something else. And then when he goes to the foul line, every time he's about to shoot, start flopping. That's all he does. So I got to say, college basketball, they do
something pretty creative.
Cool.
They're very creative.
All the fans. That's actually for every sport.
I mean, we rided in Maryland all the time. We won games.
You what?
Rided. Went down to Route 1 and ran in the streets and started fires and flipped over cars.
That's smart.
My roommate got tasered.
I've done some stupid things in my life, but come on. Really?
Yeah. Anyway, before we go into your white boy rant,
They're not making it past the Sweet 16.
Anyway, if you want to join our bracket, entries are due next Tuesday night because that's when the first round will begin. Send an email to jimmysrants@gmail.com or Facebook message us at facebook.com/theweeklyrantshow. We'll get you set up with the bracket. That's $25 to enter. And winner takes a lot of money. So if you want to join, let us know. Now, Jimmy. I gotta find some more happy music for you, because quite frankly,
where's my song?
I'm getting you your song. It's more happy music than Drink a Beer.
Well, you're trying to find that. Kel was nice enough to provide us with some sort of ideas of a rant. Provide me, rather. And I need a feeler here.
For me? I think you should do both.
Okay.
You can, you've already kind of done this.
Did I?
I think so.
Okay.
I mean, in honor of what's coming up, I think this may be a better one.
I'm game.
But you're making fun of me again, so this is just, you know.
I have to watch what I say here.
Yeah, you do. You ready?
Because I really can go off on this.
It's time for Jimmy's rant.
So the rant this week, thanks to our weight loss champion, Kelly White, who again lost 40 and a half pounds. Congratulations again, Kel.
Thank you.
That's a big thing. There you go. So, he gave me the idea of doing a rant on non-Irish people on St. Patty's Day. Trying to celebrate it.
Wait, before you do that, Kelly, are you Irish?
Very.
Does it bother you too?
Depends.
Sorry, continue.
That's why I made it a toss-up, because there are certain scenarios and situations.
Every day it's Irish, you know, everybody's Irish on St. Patty's Day is crap.
I don't, exactly. I don't like that. Now, I do know a lot of friends and family who... I know. I ranted about you, so
I know.
It is what it is.
Can I get a rant about you one day?
I'm going to rant about you in a second. I'm going to change it if you don't shut up.
Do it. Dare you.
Not yet. Maybe after this. Okay. Well, yeah. You're not Irish.
I know.
Don't you dare go out on St. Patty's Day. What are you going to do? Say, kiss me, I'm not Irish, and put a fake leprechaun or a sticker on your face and try to dress up like you're Irish, try to think you know what Guinness actually tastes like, try to do
I
an
know
actual,
exactly
like a real Irish like. Car bomb. Half you people don't even know what the hell an Irish car bomb is.
It's Baileys and Kahlua.
Oh, my God. Shut up. And it's not.
It is.
No, it's not.
No, Baileys
thank
and
you,
Jameson.
My point. If
sorry,
it's not.
It's Baileys and Jameson.
No one even drinks Irish whiskey on St. Patty's Day because half the people that actually go out are not even Irish. Because guess what? The real Irishmen, if they go out, they actually go to Irish pubs. The other people, they go to all these bars.
I go to Napper Tandy's.
That's not an Irish bar.
It's an Irish pub.
That's a club. That's a Smithtown club.
It's an Irish pub.
It is not an Irish. The first thing from an Irish pub.
It's a pub.
No, I go to O'Reilly's in the bar. O'Reilly's
in the bar. Cool.
O'Reilly's in the city. And there's three of them. And I go to one of them out there. And it's, you got to go somewhere where it's Irish. You want to be with Irish people, have a great time. Guess what? Spend some more time around them. They are great people. Don't go out there if you think you can wear a kilt. And don't go out there and think you can dress like a leprechaun like me. You don't have any Irish roots. You have
you
no reason to be
so
out there
red right now.
I know, because I'm heated and I'm drinking.
You know,
Coke.
You know what though? St. Patrick's Day, and I'm gonna get killed.
I'm also hot for wearing this freaking thing.
It's not a real holiday because I want to drink every single
it
day.
It is a holiday. You're
not
Irish. Not. Kelly, is it a holiday?
It should be a national holiday.
Thank you.
It's a Hallmark holiday. Hallmark.
It's more a holiday than Valentine's Day.
I agree with that, but still
and Halloween.
I agree with that too, but
and
again,
Day. And President's Day.
Yes, yes. These are all Hallmark holidays. St. Patrick's Day. I love drinking. I should be able to drink every day and call it a holiday.
Should be Irish history.
It should be Irish. They can do that. We do it.
Should be Irish History Month.
It should not be a special day.
Yes.
But you guys are all missing the point about
St. Patrick's. We need Irish History Month.
I think it's March.
Well, we need the surrounding months. We need February and April. Make it like a
February's
a
Black
thing.
History Month.
We can use April.
All right, your song is coming off. I
yeah.
I just don't understand where you're coming from, but St. Patrick's Day is for all the fake Irish to appreciate everything that is Irish. You know, you're thinking about
alcohol.
This. You're thinking about it from the wrong way. You're thinking about it as...
Because I'm Irish and I'm offended by all these D-bags who go out there thinking they're Irish, go out and get drunk.
Whoa, I like Fireball.
Well, I needed something that would be a crowd pleaser because he's not Irish.
But no, it's not even that.
It's American whiskey.
It is. I like my Jameson. I like my Guinness. I enjoy a good Irish car bomb. But you got to think about it this way, okay? These people who are not Irish are trying to imitate those who are Irish. And I think what's the greatest form of flattery? Than copying and imitating. Imitation is the sincerest form of flattery. I can't pronounce the freaking word. I don't understand what the hell is wrong with
me. Do you see me trying to imitate anybody else on their holidays or their historical months or anything else, any historical weeks?
It's not a real holiday. It's St. Patrick's Day. It's a made-up day.
So I have permission. I can imitate
whoever
I want.
Do you know what the hell St. Patrick's Day is about?
Intrigue me. Intrigue me. You're sitting next to me.
I have no idea.
And you're going to go out on St. Patty's Day.
I am not, actually. It's a Monday.
We're running late.
I know, and I don't want to do this anymore.
Me either. I'm sitting next to you. I'm going to punch you in the face.
Our next show will be Tuesday night at 8 p.m. Congratulations to Kelly White on losing a whopping 40 pounds. Congratulations, Dennis. Congratulations, Jim and John and myself for losing weight. And, Jimmy, you fail at life.
I saw that one coming.
You should have. You've been sitting next
no,
to me.
No, from January, I saw that one coming.
What? Oh, gaining weight? Hi, I'm Jimmy. You want to go out with me?
Oh, there's two pork chops? Great, I'll have both.
Okay. Wait, you're talking to me?
Shut up. Oh, my God, that actually happened.
hand motions and all.
No, it was after I ate, by the way.
What? No, you asked her out while.
Was it really?
It was Wall. I would not make fun of you. It was Wall.
It was Wall.
I would not make fun of you as much if you did after.
Well, you would, but
I'd make fun of you anyway. Wouldn't. Anyway, Tuesday at 8, we'll be back. We'll talk some more baseball. We'll talk some hockey. And hopefully, for the love of God, we will not be talking about any basketball. For Jimmy, I'm Steve. This is the Weekly Rant. We'll see you next Tuesday.
I'm starving. Can I get those?
Yeah.
Keep this in.
Good night, everybody.